Wow, well, truly wireless tech has apparently gotten so good and so widespread that we are seeing truly wireless AirPod-like earbuds from reputed brands at under 1000 rupee margins. I'm of course talking about the Petron Base Buds Lite. It's the budget version of the Realme Buds or the Apple AirPods or whatever. Basically a knockoff with a brand name. I was curious as to what an 800 rupees truly wireless earphone from a recognizable brand would sound, so I got my hands on these and I don't remember regretting anything more than sticking these in my ears. And I have stuck a lot of things in my ears, believe me. Well, the unboxing wasn't anything great. Typical of Petron to only include the essentials and cut the crap entirely. Well, I do love a minimal unboxing, but this thing was straight up cheap and not minimal in any way. As soon as I took this product out of its package, I was taken aback by how ridiculously cheap and flimsy feeling this thing is. I can't believe Petron would make something like this. The same people who made the Boom 2 and the Boom 3, you'll find the links for those videos, they are great earphones. Well, you know, when companies make a lot of products, they make some great ones and they make some products which they should not have made at all. Yeah, this is one of those products which Petron should never have put their brand name on. It's entirely made of this glossy finished plastic material, not a big fan of that. It has a flat base, so it sits flat on your table, which is a great thing. I am a fan of those truly wireless earbud cases which can stand upright, so I can keep them next to my monitor or next to my work desk when I'm like using them. However, I'm not happy with the footprint of this thing. This thing is way too big. And even the earbuds themselves, they are longer and thicker than the Realme Buds and the Apple AirPods themselves. And among the other crimes that Petron committed, probably this is the biggest crime of all. No magnets. Yes, I'm shocked. No magnets. Really? No, not even a single weak magnet to hold them together. Like you have to shove them in with actual brute force and you have to pull them out with the same amount of force because they rely on the actual size and the shape of this cradle to hold them in place, not the magnets. To make matters worse, the charging pin is on the bottom where the microphone typically should be. So it has to be pushed all the way in for it to start charging. There's a microphone on the back and there is a button which is a physical pressable button, not a capacitive like touch sensitive button similar to AirPods and the Realme Buds. I mean, this thing costs literally 5 times less than the Realme Buds. So I wasn't really expecting any touch capacitive controls to be present. But this button is quite tiny actually, and the glossy finish of the button with the glossy back doesn't make it easy to feel out when you're using this for the first few days. And that's the problem, because once you start playing music from this, I don't think you will use this for any more than the first few days. It's that bad. I can't believe Petron, who made those dual driver earphones, also made these. Or maybe they bought them from a third party company, which was not a good idea. After I was pretty disappointed with the build quality, I was like overall very negative about this. But when I put them in my ear, I was actually surprised as to how good and comfortable they feel. They fit me very well and like they don't move around at all. But when they finally connected and I played some media, the sound was just really, really bad. It's not even funny, it's that bad. I guess even in 2020, that's one thing you cannot get at a lesser cost. They sound even worse than an 800 rupees earphone. I mean, you get phenomenal wired earphones at this price. 800 rupees is more than enough for you to spend on actual wired, like hardcore in-ear monitor styled earphones. But in the wireless world, we still haven't caught up to that yet. 800 rupees will not get you any good kind of earphones, and they do not sound good at all. The sound is just very distant and it's tinny. The bass is muddy and the treble is just distorted. It's a total disaster. I don't think I've got a faulty unit or anything, because when the Apple AirPods first came out, there were plenty of knockoffs in the market. I have listened to some of those knockoffs and they sounded scarily similar to this. So I really don't know why Petron decided to go with a product like this when they actually have so many great ones. They are actually tainting their name and they have kind of ruined their image in my mind. I mean, they have another product in the same lineup, the Petron Base Buds. They are actually really good. Where are they? These ones. Yeah. These are the Base Buds and these are the Base Buds Lite. These are much better than the Base Buds Lite and they don't cost a lot more. I'll make a separate video comparing the two and that will also be a review of the Base Buds themselves. So stick around for that. I don't know what's going on here. How can the same company make two separate devices which are so far apart in performance and quality? Well, it's pretty obvious. Petron decided to buy bulk units from a company and they slapped their brand logo on top. Oh, Petron, I mean, I know times are tough, but really, do you have to sell products like this to make money? Now, I know that this is an 800 rupees earphone, but really, for the sake of your ear's health, if you are going to invest into a truly wireless earphone, at least be ready to spend around 1500 rupees. Because it's not about what you're getting for the money, it's about how it's going to affect you in the long term. These low quality generic earphones, they'll end up damaging your ears in the long run if you decide to use them for the sake of budget. If you cannot go above the 1000 rupee mark for your earphones, please stick with wired earphones. Because while the 1000 rupee segment is not great for wireless ones, it is fantastic for wired earphones. You will get some very high quality wired earphones in that budget segment. You can check out some of the earphones that I have made in the channel, like the Blaupunkt TM10, the Petron Boom 3, the Petron Boom 2, even the Realme Buds 2 wired. But yeah, stay away from this thing. The Petron Bass Buds Lite are just not great. Do you need more proof that these things are just cheap pieces of crap? Okay, here's one more scenario. Every time I put them on and I cover them with my palm, the connection drops. Yes, every time I put them into my ear and I cover them with my palm, they immediately disconnect and sometimes only one of them start playing and some weird stuff happens. I tried removing one earphone and covering it with my hand, covering the other earphone from my palm. It didn't happen the same way as both of them when they were in my ear. I think it's because of the range issue. As soon as you have something covering them, like your own palm, the Bluetooth connection gets so weak that the underlying chip cannot pick up the signals from the device. So yes, overall, these earphones are just a steaming pile of crap, so please don't buy them. I don't even want to bother talking about the battery life and other stuff. You will find some alternatives to these in the description, so don't buy these. Either pay more money and get the 1500 rupees or 2000 rupees options out there, or save your money and get wired earphones. Don't go for options in between, because they will not be in between. Because when it comes to budget options, there's no such thing as in between. When you're paying a little amount of money, it's either great for the money or it's crap for the money. And this thing, it's not worth it. Anyway, I hope this video saved you from buying this earphone. I really hope no one buys it. Stay tuned for a brief comparison between the Bass Buds Lite and the Bass Buds, the the higher priced version of these. And until next time, take care of your ears, and I'll see you soon.